cares? It doesn't matter.
Yes, it does! You just don't get it.
Nothing. Nothing at all.
It's definitely not nothing.
Oh, like which market stalls to eat at?
Exactly! I can't stop at all of them. I have to keep my calorie count low.
You know, you don't have to stop at any of them.
Impossible.
You sure love food. Sorry, better get this.
Alfred, can you get to the Spurious building?
Something up?
Jürgen's about to mix it up with the Skylark exchange.
Huh? Jürgen's doing what?
He's crashing some Skylark product announcement they're holding at the Spurious building.
What the hell?
Is Jürgen okay?
Apparently, he's decided to pick a fight with one of the most powerful corporations in Olympias.
That doesn't sound like a good idea.
If it was, they wouldn't be calling me. Thanks, Balin. I'm on my way. I better go check this out. Don't suppose you'd be willing to tag along? Thanks.
Can I go too and write a story about it?
You'd come even if I said no. Let's hurry to the Spurious building. Jürgen, please tell me you haven't done anything stupid. Excuse me. I heard Skylark Exchange was holding a press conference here.
I'm sorry, sir, but it's been canceled. They had some troubles with an attendee.
Troubles?
I don't suppose this attendee was wearing Kitaro clan clothes?
Pardon me, sir, but who are you exactly?
Hey!
Sorry!
We're in a hurry. Miss Vera will vouch for us.
Hello? Is anyone there?
You sure got a pair on...
And this is the time to laugh about that? We need to hurry up and find Jürgen!
Never a dull moment with you around. Here, have this. I think you could make better use of it than I could anyway. Don't bother thanking me, just take it. I always look out for my friends. Jürgen!
Alvin, what are you doing here?
Ah, you're just in time to talk some sense into your friend. I've been trying to explain to him that no one has any designs on his business plan.
So the fact that you're using my ideas, my contractors, my shipping methods, that's all just a coincidence?
Precisely. What's that saying you have in your homeland? If you eliminate the impossible, whatever remains, however improbable, must be the truth.
A coincidence, huh? Sounds more like business as usual for the Skylark Exchange.
What are you suggesting?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe that you strung Jurgen along so you could learn the ins and outs of the Rize-Maxian market, and then tried to beat him to the punch with his own big idea.
A new business opportunity comes along, and you decide that you saw it first and we stole your idea? Are those sorts of weak excuses business as usual in Rize-Maxia? I was under the impression we were trying to unify the two realms through commerce. Mr. Alfred Van Svent, will you help us achieve that goal?
What?
You've got to be kidding me.
Think about it. If we assist the fledgling markets of Rize-Maxia to stretch their wings and take flight, it will only bring your goal closer to fruition. The profits from our venture will trickle down into the economy. Everyone in Olympias will win as well.
Even if your little theory holds water, the Rize-Maxians would never stand for it. Your cutthroat business style won't fly over there.
So you're just going to turn your back on Olympias? Watch it wither on the vine?
Let's say I was interested. Is there room in your team for Jurgen?
Oh? If you want to join them, leave me out of it. And if that's the way it's got to be for you and for Rize-Maxia, so be it. I am perfectly calm.
Think long and hard about this, Alfred. Who would you rather do business with? A partner who freely shows his hand to a competitor? Or experienced businessmen with powerful connections in Olympias?
Looks like Jurgen's already gone.
Damn it, where'd he go? About what you said back there. How much of it did you mean?
All of it. Sorry to get you mixed up in this.
I don't know what kind of dealings you had with them, but this sort of thing happens all the time here. Especially after Spurious's sudden growth.
Yeah, these kinds of stories aren't even front page news in the paper anymore.
Businesses have to play dirty just to stay in the black. Yep, just another day in the cutthroat world of Olympias.
Enough! We have different values, I get it. And I'm sorry for leading you on with this, but it's just not going to happen.
What's not going to happen?
Rize-Maxians and Olympians doing business together.
So that's how you really feel, huh?
I'm sorry.
I'm not looking for an apology. Whatever. Fine. I'll pass.
Alvin. Now what?
Capable of deep thoughts, you know.
She just got a text from her big boss man. He was asking if she found the answer to his question yet.
That's all he said. No how's it going or anything.
Better give him the answer he wants this time, or it won't be pretty. The question was something about what it takes to write an article, right? So, do you have an answer yet?
When we met Agria in that fractured dimension, remember what she said about Olympians? How'd that make you feel? Right? I thought it was pretty harsh, and I'm not even from there. I feel like this directly relates to my editor's question, and how I felt interacting with the station attendant. Olympians and Rizomaxians have a different perspective. That much I know is true. But if I go beyond that simple thought, and I think about what's really important... I'll just do it. If it'll put this thing to rest, I'll write an article about what that station agent said.
Now you're sounding like the Leia we know and love. So what's next? Go interview the guy in the station again?
No, if I interview him, it'll be at the end. He's my inspiration for the piece. I need to interview a wider range of people, or the article will end up just being my own opinion. Thanks. But where to start? I want to know what real people have to say, what they're really thinking. And then I'll put those thoughts together piece by piece.
Sounds good.
All right, now I'm fired up. I'm gonna go tell my editor. Later!
You could just text him, you know. Or not.
I'm gonna write an article that will leave my editor speechless.
Speechless, huh? I can certainly visualize that, but probably not in the sense that you meant.
I don't have time for your witty repartee. Step one is research. Step two is more research. Great journalism is written with shoe leather and elbow grease.
Oh, you're not kidding around. Still, I'd bring a pen. So, do you know who you want to talk to?
Yeah. I want to interview three sources who are involved in different aspects of Rizomaxian-Olympian relations. But I don't think any of them will be easy to track down.
Why not submit your request through the Spurious Corporation's job postings? In fact, I happen to know an elite Spurious agent who seems positively enthusiastic to help.
Oh, that's a great idea. I'll give it a try. Thanks for helping me out, guys. It sure is a relief to have you around at times like this. This would be a lot harder without your support. So, here. It's my way of saying thanks for... you know... Oh, just take it already. When you're around, I have to admit, it puts me so at ease I could just doze right off. But I gotta stay up late working on my article. Thank you.
You know, even though we went our separate ways, I still feel so comfortable around you. Isn't that weird?
It's not as if we became entirely different people. That said, hearing you say that is not unpleasant. What's all this about?
Oh, nothing. Just a grump off.
The strength to protect.
Got it.
uneventful. My way.
This job is for a really rare item. I don't know if we'll find it through normal means.
Why not ask the cats to do it? They're always coming back with rare items.
Yes, I'm on another line right now. Sorry, I can't talk. Sorry, Luger. Middle of a crisis right now.
Hammer, toss! Psychic restoration! Fall! Eradicate!